The depths of the ocean will always be a mystery to us humans. We really can only get so far without fully knowing what goes on down there. For that reason, we can never give up the idea that there might be some pretty terrifying creatures down there, big enough to put on a fight with the whole human race. But we also gotta admit there are some deep sea creatures that we actually know about, even though they've only been seen a handful of times. With that said though, we're gonna be looking at 10 deep sea creatures faced by divers. Our first entry is the Pygmy Seahorse. The first creature on this list is one that was discovered by accident back in 1969. It is called the Pygmy Seahorse. This really is one tiny little seahorse, and it lives so deep in the ocean that it makes it hard for us humans to have any contact with it. Unless, of course, we become scuba divers. And even then, it's quite difficult to spot because the less than 1-inch seahorse camouflages really well with the coral where it lives. But if you look at it closely, you're gonna notice that it has a fleshy head and a body, and a long prehensile tail. What makes them so different from other seahorses is the single gill on the back of their head and the way the males brood their little ones in a pouch on their trunk, which is a very unique characteristic not only among seahorses, but among all the members of the animal kingdom. Our next entry is the whale shark. It's not really a whale, and it definitely doesn't look as much like a shark. However, the whale shark is the largest fish in the world. You don't need to be a scuba diver to be able to spot one. After all, with some snorkeling in the right spot, you should be able to see one. At least over in Mexico, the Philippines, and other countries with beautiful snorkeling spots that allow for a great experience near the whale shark. But it's significantly different when you're able to see them during a scuba diving trip. They can show up unexpectedly, and will certainly make your heart beat faster as you come face to face with a fish that can be 3 to 4 times your size. Also doesn't help when you realize they weigh about 19,000 kilos. Something interesting about the whale shark is that it can be spotted in different corners of the world. It's been noticed that some of them traveled for about 8,000 miles in less than 4 years. Hopefully, we get to keep this large fish with us for a while. They were victims to illegal fin trading for a long time, but that's thankfully slowly decreased now that people are more conscious about the importance of the environment that they have. This is also thanks in part to the efforts of all those scuba divers who have been able to interact with these creatures and realize just how cool they were. Our next entry is the Neon Slug. If you're not interested in scuba diving, this creature might make you change your mind. The Neon Slug is one of those animals that make a trip to the bottom of the ocean a memorable experience that will make you want to go back. I mean, really, just look at those awesome colors. While sea slugs are usually shorter than your pinky nails, the Neon Slug is 4 inches tall and it takes different forms and adopts different colors. They're usually dark, with green and orange stripes that make it look like someone who's about to attend a neon glow party. This creature can be found in the western Indo-Pacific part of the ocean, and is known for using toxins to defend itself against predators. It might be small, but I doubt any animals down there would really want to mess with it. Our next entry is the frilled shark. We often talk about sea creatures, and we even did some videos about sharks. Okay, actually, several. But have you heard about the frilled shark? Even though it's spread all over the Atlantic and the Pacific Oceans, this shark is considered rare, to the point that a lot of people call it a living fossil. And honestly, when you look at it, you can totally see why it got its nickname. The frilled shark certainly looks like a prehistoric creature, and looks more like an eel rather than a shark. Some experts also believe that the frilled shark is a living representative of other animals that have now gone extinct. It was only until the year of 2004 that the shark was first recorded on camera. This was a major deal, because this creature lives in the depths of the oceans, far beyond the reach of scuba divers. But this diver got really lucky, and was able to spot the strange creature. Now it is worth noting that they've come to realize that this shark probably has the longest gestation period of any other animal, including terrestrial ones. It's said that their gestation can last up to 3.5 years, and when you think about it, that's the same time it would take to gestate 4 or even 5 human babies. Also, this shark is the second largest fish in the world, measuring up to 15.2 meters long. Our next entry is the psychedelic frogfish. The next creature on this list gets its crazy name due to its coloration. When you look at it, it certainly looks like something you'd see while tripping on mushrooms or on some other kind of illegal substance you totally shouldn't do. They're small, they're stocky, and sometimes they have a lot of appendages that help them camouflage in the wild. You might have a hard time spotting one as they can easily be confused with lumps of sponge spread all over the ocean. But the thing about this fish is that they only live in the waters surrounding Ambon, Indonesia. If you see something like this anywhere else in the world, it might be another kind of frogfish or sea creature. This particular frogfish is within the group called the walking fish, because it attaches its pectoral fins to the ocean floor to move around, which makes it look as if it's walking. While other frogfish are more active in attracting and catching their prey, the psychedelic frogfish prefers to hide in cracks and crevices while waiting for its desired prey to show up. Our next entry is the red-spotted blenny. The red-spotted blenny is the kind of creature that makes you realize that the ocean really is full of amazing and unexpected creatures. There's about 800 different types of blennies in the ocean, but it takes a lot of attention and patience to be able to spot one. However, once you see them, you'll realize that they have a bit of a funny look with their puffy heads with fleshy filaments all over them. Part of the reason it's so hard to find them is because they're not as social as other creatures. In fact, they actually like to make homes in burrows and crevices, and sometimes you can even find them inside bottles. Their habitat is the Indian and Pacific Oceans, and you can find them anywhere between East Africa and the Ryukyu Islands in Japan. Our next entry is the leafy sea dragon. Although the leafy sea dragons are part of the same family as seahorses and pipefish, they look nothing like you've seen before. They get their name from their resemblance to dragons, but they're also known as leafies due to the shape of their bodies. You could easily mistake them for leaves or other sorts of ocean plants, and that's actually a good thing, because they're very slow swimmers and they could easily be attacked by their predators if it wasn't for their camouflage. Compared to other seahorses and other animals in their family, the leafy sea dragons are very large. Sometimes they can be up to 30 centimeters long. And much like other members of the seahorse family, the male leafy sea dragon is the one in charge of taking care of the fertilized eggs while carrying it under their tails. Divers who are interested in seeing this colorful and peculiar creature can find it in southern Australia, in the towns of Edithburgh and Rapid Bay. So far, that's really the only location where the leafy sea dragon's been spotted. Our next entry is the banded sea crate. I don't think many of us like to encounter snakes, especially if it's one that's able to swim, but that's exactly what the banded sea crate is, an aquatic snake. And even though it's venomous and intimidating, just like many snakes that dwell on land, this one is very cool to look at, actually. At least that's what divers say. What makes the banded sea crate so different to the regular snakes is the flat tail that allows it to swim. However, that doesn't mean this creature only lives in the water. In fact, the sea crate goes up to the surface to digest its prey, reproduce, and of course, to just take a small break. After all, they're not as fast on land as they are underwater, so they need to take things slow once they come ashore. And even though we can probably find one of these animals without being able to dive, the people who have seen them underwater claim that seeing them in underwater action can be pretty exciting. They're especially cool when they're part of large hunting parties. And again, let me repeat this, they're venomous, but just like most of the other venomous animals, the banded sea crates only attack when they feel frightened. You should be fine if you're part of a diving group and you just want to watch them. Just don't try to touch them. Now it's time for today's best pick. Now, the picture I have for you today shows a creature that a lot of us are familiar with. It is a jellyfish. However, I don't think I have seen any jellyfish like the one in this picture. Let's find out more about it with the lion's mane jellyfish. The lion's mane jellyfish, also known as the giant jellyfish or the hair jelly, is one of the largest living organisms in the world. But as opposed to the common jellyfish types that have stung us during our tropical holidays or stung SpongeBob, the giant jellyfish prefers to live in the cold. You can find it in the northern Pacific, the northern Atlantic, and around the boreal waters of the Arctic. This creature uses its 120 feet long tentacles to capture, pull in, and devour its prey, which includes fish, other jellyfish, and many other sea creatures. It is these trailing tentacles that gave the creature its name, because if you look at it, you can easily see how it resembles the look of a lion's mane. The bell of these jellyfish is split into 8 different parts, and each part can have between 70 to 150 tentacles. That's a lot of tentacles, and I definitely feel sorry for any fish or sea creature that crossed the path of this beast. When it comes to humans, the sting of this jellyfish can cause localized redness and temporary pain. But if you're a diver and you encounter one of these at a deeper level, you might experience a panic attack and perhaps drowning. However, none of these things should make us stay away from a diving experience. Seeing these creatures in the wild can certainly be scary, but it's surely really gonna blow your mind. As long as it doesn't kill you first. Before we move on, do me a favor. My analytics show that only about 15% of you watching are actually subscribed. Come on guys, what's up with that? Can you guys please hit the subscribe button? You guys watch my videos every day anyway, so you might as well subscribe and keep up to date with every video we put out. Number 1. The strawberry squid. There's nothing more rewarding than going out on a late night dive to find fluorescent creatures swimming in the deep sea. It's said about 90% of deep sea animals are able to produce bioluminescence. Bioluminescence means, in other words, that they're able to glow in the dark. For that reason, divers who are also photographers like to dive late at night and explore these creatures and capture them with their cameras. Back in 2015, someone was able to capture the strawberry squid glowing in the dark. It was the first time that someone got a picture of it. While the creature is normally a bright red color, it turns into an eerie blue in the right circumstances. The ability to glow in the dark helps animals to protect themselves from predators. They do this by lighting up the underside of their body with a dim glow, which hides their upper body from predators below them. If you ever get a license to practice scuba diving, you really should look into it. It's pretty neat. There's no way we can witness these things unless we take a deep dive into the ocean at the right time of the night. But tell me, have you seen any of these creatures personally? If not, which one would you like to see someday? Let us know in the comments section down below. And with all that said and done, that's our video for today, folks, and I will see you all next time. Later, everybody!